Don't come over here and get up in my face and try to get confrontational with me. Okay? So why don't you turn around and go back where you came from?
No, I'm right here.
Well, I don't like you right here, and I didn't ask you to come over here. So is there anything else you needed?
No.
Then turn around and go about your way.
I'm not going to turn around and go away.
Well, I guess neither am I then. You want to have an argument? We'll have an argument.
You're being ridiculous.
Am I being ridiculous? No, I think you were being ridiculous, and now you're getting your ass called out. So now you want to keep going. You don't know when to shut the up.
I simply asked you if you had a problem with
And this. I told you what my problem was. You want to keep going? Because I can have a long list of problems.
Again, I told you where you take it up.
And I told you where you could go.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Got him. These are Denver area cops, according to the narrative here. We have not been able to independently confirm the identity of the particular officer or officers who were present during this. But it's worthy to highlight that this woman told them what they were going to do. She said, you're going to turn around. You're going to walk away. He said, no, I'm not. She said, yes, you are. And proceeded to make the man turn around and walk away. Now, remember, obviously, she has committed no criminal action, which means there's no necessity for law enforcement engagement. And he was aware of that. But I have to wonder if this would have been anybody other than her, would the results have been the same? Let's say if I was arguing with this officer and his buddies were in the background, and I told him, you need to turn your ass around and walk away from me. Would he have the same response to me as he had to this woman in front of him? I would say probably not, okay? It is interesting. He did his best to hold on to the little power that he had. He was trying to be intimidating, trying to be adversarial. But in the end of the day, he did walk away with all of his little cop buddies who in the background, who obviously did not want any of that smoke. This is a highlight in anti-Karenicity. Ben, thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, watching that video, my heart was racing. I was like terrified of like, because like we know how cop videos like turn out, right? Like that's like half of the stuff we cover on Indisputable here, right? So like that was like terrifying, but it's also like, I don't, yeah, like if you're a police officer, right, you should understand who you are and you shouldn't be in a space where you're not welcome or wanted because you're just gonna put people on edge. And it's just so wild to compare this to like, so I was in the military, I was stationed in Germany for like 4 years. And in Germany, their police, it's so wild. They stay at the station until they're called for and then they show up. And then when they're done, they just go back to the station. They don't really depend on regular patrols, which means that police just typically aren't in spaces where they're not asked to be explicitly. And this kind of thing, believe it or not, doesn't really happen there. Big surprise, I know. And it turns out that Germany isn't crumbling or burning to the ground because of all the anarchy and chaos. It actually is a bit safer and the police officers don't kill random innocent people. So that really, I think, is at like the heart of this. So it's nice to see people like stand up and say, hey, what are you doing here? But also at the same time, it is pretty terrifying because not everybody can do that. I think we all know that if it was anybody other than a white woman in that situation, it would be a completely different story.
Oh, for sure.